Sunil is a half conductor or semiconductor. So we should never get confused between two words. There is a topic called single phase half wave converter. Half wave converter means it is only one SCR, the circuit which contains only one SCR. So half-wave converters, the circuit which contains only one SCR, is never used practically. So we use semi-converter or half-converter circuits. So half-converter circuits, this is with the inductive load. So symmetrical, we got the symmetrical combination, asymmetrical combination. So symmetrical in the sense, this is the circuit. Whereas in asymmetrical, here we are having the T1 and just beside the T1 we are having the D1. So we go for the symmetric approach, circuit combination. So now let us focus on this particular single phase semi-converter or half converter or half controlled converter. So in the external examination, if you get single phase half controlled converter or semi-converter, that circuit is entirely followed by two SCRs and two diodes. One more challenging question is, till now nobody has designed the converter circuit with three SCRs. Remember this point. Many engineers have designed with two SCRs or with four SCRs. For three phase it is six SCRs. But the challenge is, if you are really understanding how the current starts to flow and in which direction the current has to move, ultimate our aim is to convert bidirectional current to unidirectional. You can also try the circuits with the three SCRs or five SCRs. Okay, we'll see the mathematical part later on. Yeah. So single phase semi-converter with inductive load. Remember one point, whether it is inductive load or resistive load, the waveforms, expressions, voltage equations of semi-converter for both the loads will be same. So what is output voltage of the semiconductor, we'll see later. So first, today's class, I repeat this one for the very last time, and I want the explanation from you people, even the notes also for this topic. So this is a circuit. So with this connection, with this arrangement only, we can convert the bidirectional current to unidirectional. Anyone student, please tell me how to confirm that DC current is flowing through the load or AC current is flowing through the load. Anyone student, you can unmute and tell me. So I am giving you one load. Okay. So how to confirm that DC current or AC current is flowing through the load without connecting any meter? If the direction of the current flowing through the load is in same, is same for positive off cycle and for negative off cycle, then the current flowing through the load is dash current. Which current, anyone? If the current flowing through the load is in same direction during positive off cycle and during negative off cycle, then the type of current is called, yes, all the students, is called unidirectional current, right? So now let us get into this one. So what is the explanation? Semiconductor. So why, what is a special advantage of semiconductor, anyone? Last class also I mentioned, semiconductors provide high voltage than fully controlled converters. Semi-converters provides good power factor and compared with the full control converters. Semi-converters cost is cheap when compared with the full converters. Semi-converters application. Semi-converters are used when the motor has to be rotated only in one direction. If you see in a cement industry or paper mill industry, okay, or in escalator, the movement will be only in one direction. So where, what type of control technique we can use? We can use the semiconductor. If I want the movement of the motor in both the directions, we cannot use the semiconductor. So this is very important. Okay. So semiconductor as we require the movement only in one direction, we can eliminate other two SCRs, and those two SCRs are replaced by the power driver, not ordinary driver. Okay. So why the circuit? Why we are having SCRs and diode combination? Now it is clear, I think. Because we can control the speed of the motor only in one direction, that is from 0 to 180 or from 180 to 360. Either one. So therefore, for only one cycle operation, we can go with the diode. We'll go with the explanation. Come on, who will tell the starting explanation? I hope every student is perfect with this one. During the positive off cycle of input AC supply, and today's class will be the last class for this topic, okay? This type of introduction. To make a point clear, this one, our explanation will be far better than the textbooks, what they are mentioned in an easy manner. Okay. During positive off cycle of input AC supply, voltage at point A is greater than voltage at point B. So we should assume here A and B. A is nothing but the phase and B is nothing but the neutral. Voltage at point A is greater than voltage at point B. Therefore, direction of the current starts from which point? Voltage at point A is greater than voltage at point B. Therefore, we say the direction of the current during positive off cycle, you can see. Direction of the current start from the point. This is the first explanation. Second, for SCR T1 or for SCR 1 during positive off cycle, current is entering first which terminal? Anode terminal. For SCR T1 or for SCR 1 during positive off cycle, current is entering the anode terminal first. Therefore, voltage at anode is greater than voltage at cathode, and hence SCR operates in which state? Forward blocking state, with the J1 and J3 forward biased and J2 is reverse biased. Now with the help of UJT firing circuit, if a firing pulse is applied to the gate terminal of SCR, then the SCR turns on. The firing pulse is applied to the gate terminal of SCR, SCR turns on completely. When SCR is on, it is just like a copper wire. It will allow 100% of current to flow through it. The current cannot flow through this diode because the current is entering which terminal? Cathode terminal. If the current enters first the cathode terminal, voltage at cathode is greater than voltage at anode. Therefore, the diode is off. It is open. So, this paragraph we are supposed to write. So, the current flows through the T1, and then already we have discussed, is similar to the full converter, then to the load. Here the load, inductive load means example, motor, which is having the winding. And already I mentioned, whenever we are explaining the inductive load, anyone tell me what is the inductor here? So we should write certain points. Inductor L in the circuit is very large value inductor. Inductor L represents the combination of windings of motor plus the large value of inductor, which is used to provide the continuous current. So continuous current is available only if I am using in my circuit large value of inductor. Okay. So what is this inductor? If somebody asks you in this circuit, it is not just a simple inductor placed in the circuit. Inductor, this inductor is a combination of windings of the inductor. It represents the windings, armature and field windings, if it is a DC motor, plus the large value of inductor, externally connected large value of inductor, which is used to provide the continuous current. So we all know current starts flow from source plus Vs plus, that is A to S1, S1 to load, and from load to the T1, and from T1 to the point B. As I mentioned, if you understand one topic, you know, everything will be simple. So during negative off cycle, okay, and we should never call this one as positive and negative terminal. It is only representing the direction of the current. During negative off cycle of input AC supply, voltage at point B is greater than voltage at point A. Therefore, direction of the current starts from the point B. You can see during negative off cycle, direction of the current starts from the point B. Now you can see this graph here for explanation. Okay? Now we are giving firing pulse to which SCRs, which SCR we are giving the firing pulse to the T2 and next. Only T2, okay, only single firing pulse, D2 will be automatically turned on. So we should represent the direction of the current flow. So from B to T2, T2 to the load, and from low to the, so already D1 will be off and it flows to the D2, from D2 to the point A. So during lift off cycle, the direction of the current is from B to T2, T2 to the load, and load to the point D2, and from D2 to the point. So during this process, positive of cycle and negative of cycle, yes. If the firing angle, here we have tried one more case. If firing angle, we are selecting less than 90. If the firing angle is less than 90, so what's going to happen? If the firing case, three cases we have tried. Case one, let us assume the firing angle alpha equal to 30 degrees. C1 is fired at alpha equal to 30 degrees. When firing angle is minimum, maximum energy is transferred from source to load. What SCR will do? When SCR is on, it transfers the maximum energy from source to. So case two, what is the case two? When firing angle is alpha equal to 90 degrees. So suppose you want the inductive load, the speed of the motor should be medium. So case one, firing angle alpha is taken at alpha equal to 30 degrees for maximum speed of the motor. Case 2, alpha equal to 90 degrees for medium speed of the motor. So when, now case 3 we move, case, and you are supposed to write a simple theory, what you have discussed. Case 3 is what? Alpha equal to left, alpha equal to 120 degrees. For which speed, maximum speed or minimum speed? All of you. So only one point you have to remember. Firing angle minimum, maximum power, maximum speed of the motor. Now firing angle is alpha equal to 120. Minimum speed of the motor and minimum power at the output terminal. These three cases we just put and it finishes the theory. Now let us say the graphical part and derivative part. Okay, as we have done fully controlled current, same thing. Only the point is semiconductors are operated between the angle 0 to 180 or 180 to 360. But fully controlled converters can provide the control from 0 to 360. Semiconductors are used to operate the motor only forward direction. So forward direction means only one movement, that means clockwise direction or upward direction if it is a lift. Okay. That is the only difference. And now, yes, most important objective question in the complete examination, semiconductor is used up to the power ratings 15 kilowatts. Remember this point, 15 kilowatts. It can be used more than 15 kilowatts. We are going for the three-phase system. Okay. If a motor rating is 15 kilowatts, we can run that particular motor with this converter circuit. We can control the speed. Okay. We got the input and supply. Already I mentioned, no need to show these dotted lines while you are explaining in the examination. Just draw the input VI or VS 0 to 5, the input AC signal. We are having input AC signal and then at certain angle, we are applying pulse signal to the SCR. Now you can say by default we take alpha equal to 30 degrees. This will come as the 30 degrees. Now at this 30 degrees, we are applying the firing pulse to which SCR during positive of cycle? T1. So now a pulse signal is applied. It is, pulse signal is not shown here. So V0 is what we are showing the output voltage. When pulse signal is applied, yes. When SCR is on, input energy is transferred from source to the load. You can see this particular portion is transferring from source to the load. Okay, so when SCR is turned on at alpha equal to 30. So this is the input and output voltage waveform. Output voltage follows exactly the input voltage. You can see. Now, what we have to write? At alpha equal to 30 degrees, SCR T1 is turned on, energy is transferred from source to. These points are highlighted. This is very important. At alpha equal to 30 degrees, SCR T1 is turned on and energy is transferred from source to load. Output voltage follows the input voltage. Now, next case, at omega t is equal to 180. Now, I am expecting the answer from any one student. What happens at omega t is equal to 180? At alpha equal to 30, we have explained. Now, what happens at omega t or alpha equal to 30 degrees? This x-axis is omega t. Anyone? At omega t or alpha equal to 180 degrees, input voltage is zero. Direct words we are supposed to put. Okay, the mathematical words, no need of any English essay writing. So at omega t is or alpha equal to 180 degrees, input voltage is equal to zero. Output voltage is also equal to zero. And hence, the SCR T1 and hence the voltage across the SCR T1 also becomes zero. But inductor, but inductor will store the energy. The current flowing through the inductor is not equal to zero. What is the explanation? The current flowing through the inductor is not equal to zero. Therefore, inductor will not release the entire energy. Inductor will not release the entire energy at omega t equal to 180 degrees. And inductor current will be maximum at this 180 degrees. That with respect to the current waveform, we are supposed to put. Now, we go with the current waveform. Yes, in this animation, it is shown the horizontal line. But in the examination, we should show energizing of inductor. Inductor current will be maximum at omega t is equal to 180 degrees for large values of inductor. So why you are drawing like that? One more animation I'll show you. Here, in few textbooks and a few materials, we are having the only this one. So no need of this thyristor current and all those things. So what happens at omega t is equal to 180 degrees? Inductor current becomes maximum. Input voltage, output voltage equal to zero. Inductor is not de-energized. Inductor is storing the maximum energy at omega t is equal to 180 degrees. This is very important point. Now we move to the next case. So at omega t is equal to beta, beta is equal to pi plus alpha at this point. Okay. So what you see the next cycle. Now after 180 degrees, the second cycle starts. Okay. But I cannot turn on the SCR T2 at this point because already T1 is conducting. Therefore here T1, D1 are conducting. And that inductor is de-energizing now. You can see the de-energized current representation here. So at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha or beta is equal to pi plus alpha, we give firing pulse to the SCR T2. And during this process, SCR T1 is completely off. And when SCR T2 is on, the input energy is transferred from input to output, but in the same direction because the current flowing through the load is in same direction as we all know. The current flowing through the node is in the same direction. This is simple basic. If input is negative of cycle, but why we are getting the signal above the axis? Because the current flowing through the node during positive of cycle or during negative of cycle, it is flowing in same direction. Therefore, we get the graph above the axis. So at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, T2 is on and T1 is turned off and the energy is transferred from source to load during negative of cycle also. So what happens between pi to pi plus alpha, this region, you can see here T1, T2, the inductor starts to de-energize here, this particular. So this is small graph what they have mentioned, it is the inductor de-energizing. So this process repeats. So let us repeat what happens at omega t is equal to 2 pi. At omega t is equal to 2 pi or alpha equal to 2 pi, input voltage is equal to 0. Output voltage is also equal to zero, but inductor current is not zero. The current flowing through the motor is not zero because inductor will never release the energy suddenly. Inductor will not de-energize suddenly. Inductor de-energizes exponentially. So inductor releases the stored energy after a certain period of time. So what is the time? It is at 2 pi plus alpha. So at omega t is equal to 2 pi, inductor current is maximum. Input voltage is zero, output voltage is zero. And even SCR T2 is not turned off, so inductor current will become zero at which angle? At omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha. So in this way, as any question is there, you can ask me in a voice or in the chat also. So in this way, we can complete the explanation. So three stages we have tried. After giving the theory explanation, and then we have tried case 1 at omega t is equal to alpha, case 2 at omega t is equal to 180 degrees, and case 3 omega t equal to 2 pi. That's it. Three cases. What's going to happen? Okay. So inductive load is nothing more than. So now we see what is the output voltage. When we say we are converting AC to DC, we are not getting pure DC here. We are not placing the capacitors. Filter circuits are not present. That is what is the BTEC syllabus. Okay. So now we move to the output expression. So we are having two voltages, one is AC and DC, RMS and average voltage. Okay. So for converters always we have to derive the expression for average voltage. So already we have taken this derivation. The most important point in the power electronics without confusion is, remember, fully controlled converter output voltage means average voltage with resistive load. What is expression? Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Fully controlled converter output voltage with freely wheeling diode. Anyone tell me what is the expression with freely wheeling diode for inductive load? Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Semi converter. Okay. Semi converter, whether it is resistive load or inductive load, the output expression will be Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. This already we have derived, so no need to get confused here. Semi converter, whether it is inductive load or resistive load. Okay. So since we are having the diodes and the CRTs, the output voltage is how much? Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Okay. So now we go for the next topic. No need to study the RMS voltage here as per the syllabus, because we are converting AC to DC. We are concentrating on average voltage. So now we move to the single phase semi converter with RLE load. Okay. So all the students, this is very important, this particular topic. So we take the problem also. So what we have to write for the RLE load? The most important. So same similar points will be repeated. But what new point we have to write, I'm just going to highlight right now. Okay. So RLE load definition is what? If the motor back EMF is taken into consideration, then the load, RL load, is represented as RLE load. For RL load or inductive load, the motor back EMF value is assumed to be zero, it is neglected. And RLE load contains the effect of back EMF, motor back EMF. We already know every motor acts as a generator, it generates small amount of electric voltage. Now, this is the RLE load. Practical loads, what type of loads we are having maximum? When we consider, we are having the RLE. So what is explanation? So same explanation here. During positive off cycle of input AC supply, what you should never forget this one. So I'll ask at the end of the class anyone student with roll number, so listen carefully. During the positive off cycle of input AC supply, voltage at point A is greater than voltage at point B. Therefore, direction of the current starts from the point A. For SCR T1, what's going to happen? Current enters first the anode terminal. Therefore, voltage at anode is greater than voltage at cathode, and SCR T1 is turned on. So you see the direction. During positive off cycle, voltage at point A. Why I'm repeating number of times? Because you should never forget this explanation. You should put it on your own words. Voltage at point A is greater than voltage at point B. Therefore, direction of the current starts from the point A. This is the direction. For SCR T1, current enters the first anode terminal. Therefore, voltage at anode is greater than voltage at cathode. And hence, SCR T1 is forward biased with junctions J1 and J3 forward biased and junction J2 reverse biased. Now, with the help of UJT, if a firing pulse is applied to the gate terminal of SCR T1 is on, it operates under forward conducting state. Complete explanation of that. So now the direction of the current flows through the T1, via A to T1, T1 to the load. Now you can ask one question, sir, back EMF is present. Whether it will go through the battery or it will come back from the motor. Now, first case here, when we are explaining for RLE load explanation, case 1. Alpha less than 90 degrees. Entire explanation, what we are doing? Alpha less than 90 degrees. When firing angle is less than 90 degrees with that operation, the input source voltage is greater than the voltage across the volt, is greater than the back EMF voltage. Therefore, the current flows from source to the load. This is the most crucial point. So for RLE load, case 1, if the firing angle alpha is maintained less than 90, the source voltage, input source voltage value is greater than the back EMF value, and hence the current flows from source to the load and power is transferred from source to the load. Therefore, this back EMF value is very much less now. For firing angle less than 90, the entire energy is transferred from source to the load. You know which one is on. So T1, current flows to this T1, RLE load, and then back to the T1. I'll explain why we are placing the freely wheeling diode. Why not it is placed in inductive load? Why it is placed here? Okay. So now this is finished. Okay. Now the new explanation. During positive off cycle of input AC supply, when current flows through the inductor, inductor starts to energize. Inductor stores energy. Inductor stores energy in the form of magnetic field. So So this is the new explanation. In fact, during the cost of cycle of input as supply, inductor starts to energize, inductor stores magnetic energy. Okay. So what are the terminals here? This one will be positive and here it will be negative. I cannot put in the animation. Now you can remember this upper one is a positive and here it is negative because current is entering this terminal. So inductor is energizing, inductor is storing certain amount of energy. Now this part is done. Okay. So during positive of cycle, what's going to happen? Now I'm coming back to the new explanation here. So this is the new thing for the RLE load. What you have to write. Listen carefully with this diagram. Okay. During positive cycle, don't see this minus and plus. Okay. Now you see. What is the third paragraph? First paragraph, during positive cycle, A is greater than B. Direction of current starts from the point A. Second paragraph, during positive cycle for SCR T1, voltage at anode is greater than voltage at cathode. Therefore, SCR T1 is on and current starts to flow through the SCR T1 and certain direction which you have given. During positive cycle of input as supply, inductor starts to energize. Inductor stores energy and inductor creates the magnetic field. So you can ask why you are placing inductor and why magnetic field is created. Now you got the answer. Imagine electric train is approaching a railway station. Practically you can mention in examination. Imagine an electric train is approaching a railway station. So when electric train is approaching the station, nearby station, the supply to that electric train will be turned off, entire supply. When supply is turned off also, the electric train has to move in forward direction and it has to reach the exact destination. So inductor now, which has energized completely, starts to de-energize or starts to release the stored energy. So when inductor is energized completely, the inductor voltage across the inductor is greater than the back EMF of the. Therefore, during positive cycle only, when inductor starts to de-energize, when the input supply is off, inductor starts to de-energize, the de-energized current travels from L plus. Now, for inductor, the terminals gets reversed. For capacitor, it will never get reversed. So initially this was plus and here it was minus. Now what's going to happen when inductor is de-energizing? This particular terminal becomes positive. So what is a de-energized current direction? L plus to back EMF. Inductor voltage is greater than back EMF. Therefore current starts to flow from L plus to back EMF. Back EMF to diode. And from diode to the resistor. Resistor to the load. So this is the advantage of placing the freely wheeling diode in the semiconductor circuit, because when motor is present in the motor is acting as load, I want to rotate the motor even when the power supply is off. Can we rotate the motor without power supply continuously? No, because inductor cannot store the energy permanently. So I hope everybody understood what is the real application of placing the large value of inductor to provide continuous current and to run the motor continuously. So I repeat this statement. During positive cycle, A is greater than B, that's okay. And how the current direction flows, that's okay. Third one is what? Third paragraph. During positive cycle, inductor starts to energize. Inductor stores energy. During positive cycle, when the power supply is turned off, inductor releases the stored energy, that is inductor starts to de-energize. So when the inductor is de-energizing, the de-energized current travels from L plus to back EMF and from back EMF to the diode and from diode to the resistor to the back L minus. This is very important, which is not mentioned in any textbook. You can check the power electronics textbooks. What happens? What is the direction? So what is the application? During this process, when inductor de-energizes in the absence of input supply also, the motor continuously rotates in forward direction and the electric train moves towards the station. So this happens in the positive cycle. Now we move to the this particular negative cycle. Yes, during negative cycle, voltage at point B is greater than voltage at point A. Therefore, direction of the current starts from the point B. And for SCR T2, the voltage at anode, current is entering first the anode terminal. Therefore, voltage at anode is greater than voltage at cathode. Therefore, the SCR T2 is on with the help of firing pulse. So current travels from B to T2 and T2 to the load, okay, and from load to the back to the SCR D2 and to the A. So B to T2 load, and you can assume here always the current is ending, the back end of effect is less. Entire explanation we are giving for alpha less than 90 degrees. Remember that case one. The current flows in this manner, negative of second. So load to the D2, D2 to the point A. Okay. So what this is what in under the negative of second. Now we are going for the explanation under the case B. Any guesses? Case B, alpha greater than 90. Now this is important. What is line commutated inverter? Line commutated inverter is nothing but fully controlled converter, not the semi converter. Yeah. So fully controlled converter, when it is operating, for semiconductor this will be the explanation. Fully controlled converter, I'll explain that particular part. Remember, try to remind me in future the line commutated inverter, that word discuss later. But semi converter, this part is done. We go with the explanation alpha less than 90. Anyone tell me why I should not explain alpha greater than 90? Because semi converters can control the speed of the motor only in how many directions? One direction. Therefore, this is the explanation. It's a complete explanation. Now we'll just look at the graphs. Input voltage and output voltage. Now we have to give the explanation. As I mentioned, this is the correct graph of the inductor current. Never draw horizontal line in the examination. Okay, so input voltage. So what happens at the omega t is equal to alpha? At omega t is equal to alpha, T1 and D1 are turned on and the energy is transferred from source to load. Inductor current starts to energize. And at omega t is equal to pi, at 180 degrees, what's going to happen? Input voltage is zero. Output voltage is zero, but inductor current is maximum. So this is most important to competitive exam question. At omega t is equal to 180 degrees, what is the value of inductor current? Inductor current is maximum. You can see inductor is completely energized to the maximum value. So the SCR cannot turn off. So at what point it will turn off? It will turn off after 180 degrees. That is 180 plus alpha, which is taken as the beta. Now, next explanation. What happens at omega t is equal to, what happens between pi to 2 pi plus, pi to pi plus alpha. So, pi plus alpha we'll see here. In the animation. Concentrate up to these three graphs only. So, what is pi plus alpha? This particular part where we are giving firing pulse to the SCR T2 and D2 is the pi plus alpha. So, between pi and pi plus alpha, there is no conduction. Okay, all the current voltage value is zero and the inductor starts to de-energize. Inductor starts to de-energize from pi to pi plus alpha and at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, next case. So first case is, any number you can put, that is not the question. At what happens at omega t is equal to alpha, SCR T1 and D1 are turned on. At omega t is equal to pi, voltages are zero, but the inductor current is maximum. Inductor is not de-energized completely. And at omega, between pi to pi plus alpha, inductor current starts to de-energize. And at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, this is important. At omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, inductor releases the complete stored energy. Now you can see here, this is what the omega t is equal to pi plus alpha. At omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, inductor releases the complete stored energy. Now we can apply firing pulse to the SCR T2. Therefore, T2 and D2 will be on. And once again, inductor starts to de-energize. So what is the proof that continuous current is flowing? You can see this current graph is never touching the x-axis. It never becomes zero. So it might increase or decrease, but it is flowing continuously. So as an engineer, what we are supposed to do, we should create filter circuit which will make this particular energizing, de-energizing current be a constant current. That is what you will study in the higher level. So how to filter out this one, and this particular explanation. So any doubts I am expecting from your end, because for this theory, it will be the last class, the topic, full converter. Any small doubt you reason, you can ask any student. Yavarki iruna doubt adagandi, simple. The same thing. So three cases we explained at alpha, omega t is equal to alpha, at omega t is equal to pi, between pi to pi plus alpha, inductor starts to de-energize, at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, inductor releases the complete stored energy, inductor current is zero, and at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, T2 is given the firing pulse, once again the inductor starts to energize. this process is a continuous process. So pi plus alpha is nothing but we are assuming it as the beta. Yesterday in the problem we have seen the pi plus alpha, we are assuming it as the beta. Okay, that's why continuous current means what is the formula? Beta is equal to pi plus alpha. So this, now let us see the expression. The top three graphs are sufficient to explain the examination. Once again, average output voltage will be the same. So whether it is semiconductor, whether it is resistor load, RL load or RLE load, the output voltage will be same. Okay, Vm by pi into cos alpha, no need to take the RMS voltage. So I thought of taking the dual converter. Dual converter will take it in the next class, but one problem I am giving as assignment, you can take this. All the students, yes, problem you are able to see on the screen. Anyone confirm?
Yes, sir.
So this problem, you calculate only DC output voltage means average output voltage. And what is the power factor formula? Yesterday we have taken 2 root 2 by pi cos alpha. And no need to solve the RMS quantities because it is related to the AC converter. Okay. So a single phase full converter and semi converter, you can see, are used for two cases. What is the case one firing angle? Pi by 4. Case 2 is nothing but pi by 3. So pi by 3 is 60 and it becomes pi by 4, you can take 45. Determine the output voltage. So full converter with inductive load, you take this one. Okay, load is inductive load. So now you tell me how to solve this problem. A single phase full converter, we keep the sidetrack first. A single phase full converter for inductive load without freely wheeling diode. Without freely wheeling diode, we have to solve. Now anyone tell me, what is the formula of fully controlled converter without freely wheeling diode for inductive load? Come on, fast.
2Vm by pi.
Very good, very good, very good, very good. 2Vm by pi cos alpha. So now, what is the disadvantage of this expression? Output voltage is very much less. Therefore, what engineers have done in order to improve the output voltage, in order to make the motor rotate continuously, freely wheeling diode is placed in full converters also. But when freely wheeling diode is placed in full converters, we cannot run the motor for forward direction and backward direction. So remember, with freely wheeling diode, the full converter is used only for one direction. Without freely wheeling diode, it is used for both the directions. So second case is single phase full converter with freely wheeling diode. Now tell me anyone, what will be the formula with freely wheeling diode? Single phase full converter with freely wheeling diode, what is the formula? Vm by pi
into, Vm by pi
into 1 plus cos.
Very good, very good. Vm by pi into 1 plus cos. Okay, then we can do for both the cases, just calculate the output average voltage. Now what happens for semiconductor? Just now we have taken semiconductor, only one formula, Vm by pi into 1 plus cos alpha. Okay. So that part you can do, you solve that one. Okay. So I'm just taking the screenshot of our attendance. If possible, Monday I will take one online exam, object to type. Okay. It is just casual exam only. It will be for 5 minutes only. Chat only, 18 people have entered in the chat box.